There is no such thing. A plus B plus C equals 270 degrees. How are they getting 270 degrees here? They're trying to say that's a 90, that's a 90, and that's a 90. It's not. Can't be a 90. These are not 90 degree angles. It's rubbish. How can a triangle have three 90 degree angles within it? It can't. But you can, from a central point, have three 90 degree angles. You can make a load of different spherical triangles on the surface of this sphere, but they're not triangles. They're just three curved lines meeting. There's no measurement you can make. It can't be done. It's impossible to measure spherical triangles.
So I guess this is impossible, right? Well, you won't mind me showing you how it is possible using no math, no trig, just geometry. Here I have 3 points, 3 sides, and 3 angles on this unit sphere. Each side is the shortest straight line surface path between 2 points, and all are part of great circles. And you can clearly see the intersect path of one of these circles when I cut the sphere with a plane OAB, making the blue line, together with the points A and B, part of both the sphere and the plane. Cutting the sphere again with another plane, OAC, makes it easy to see 2 surfaces from which we can measure an angle. What was it you said again?
Cambridge Dictionary. The space between 2 lines or surfaces at the point at which they touch each other are measured in degrees.
When we look down on the sphere directly above point A, it's pretty obvious that angle A is 90 degrees. And resetting the view shows us an equilateral spherical triangle with 3 right angles. If I place a horizontal plane at point A, the angle we're measuring becomes even more obvious. One thing to notice is, the greater the area the triangle covers, the greater the excess becomes. And if I make the triangle as big as possible, you'll also notice the angle sum to 540 degrees, which is the same as 3 straight angles.
All they're doing is they're taking this radius that they know they have, and they're taking 3 lines from a center point, let's just say in simplistic form, like here, by using very simplistic XYZ 90 degree angles from a center point. And then they have chords running here, here, and here, and they're calculating what this arc would be for each tree.
Have you tried measuring the angles subtended at the center to see if they match the angles at the surface? I think you'll find that they don't.
Now, I have plotted on Google Earth a course between 3 airports, Ted Stevens Airport, LAX, and JFK Airport in New York, and I've put those angles in the illustration. Now, if you add those together, you come up with a triangle that has 191 internal degrees. That means that we have a spherical excess of 11 degrees.
Well, what do you know? 191 degrees total. And 11 degrees excess. Now I wonder who Bob is voting for this year. Well, that's another Brian's Logic video covered, although it could equally apply to Brian Leakey and the Try Thinking Gang. I'll put a link in the description for Bob's nomination video, do check that out, and there'll be a link in there too for Brian's channel, so you can go over there and check out his latest offerings.
Thanks for watching.